If A and B are symmetric matrices of same order, then show that AB is symmetric if and only if A and B come. So here the given condition, A and B are symmetric matrices. That means given A transpose is equal to A and B transpose equal to B. So this is the condition, that is A and B are symmetric. Now we have to show that AB is symmetric if and only A and B come. It is same as the meaning of AB is symmetric is AB whole transpose equal to AB if and only the meaning of A and B commute is the commutative property holds, that is AB equal to B. So to prove AB whole dash equal to AB if and only if AB equal to B. So in this problem we have to do both the direct and converse part. So in the first case we have to assume the direct part, that is we have to assume AB is symmetric, then we have to prove AB equal to B. So first we will assume AB is symmetric, that is AB whole transpose is equal to A. I will take this as equation 1. Now by the property of transpose of a matrix, we have the property AB whole transpose is equal to B transpose into A transpose. But by the given condition, B transpose is equal to B and A transpose equal to A. So I will take this as equation 2. Now see both equation 1 and 2. In the both equation, the left hand side is same. So we can equate the right hand side. Therefore, from equation 1 and 2, we get AB equal to B. So this is the direct part, that is we are assuming AB is symmetric and we prove AB equal to B. Now the converse part, that is here we have to assume AB will come in, that is we have to assume AB equal to BA and we have to prove AB is symmetric. Now for that, consider AB whole transpose. By the property of transpose of the matrix, AB whole transpose is equal to B transpose into A transpose. Since they are given B and A are symmetric, B transpose equal to B and A transpose equal to A. Now we already assumed that both AB and B are equal. So in the place of BA, I can write matrix A. So we get AB whole transpose equal to AB. This implies AB is symmetric. So we proved both the direct part and converse part. So we can say that if A and B are symmetric matrices of the same order, then AB is symmetric if and only if A and B come. Thank you. 102x will be 0 minus. That is, the product of these three matrices must be 0. And you have to find for all values of x, this will be 0. Now, first we will find order of this. This is matrix of order 1 cross 3. And this is of order 3 cross 3. And this matrix is of order 3 cross 1. So, first you can multiply these two or these two. So, solution. So, I will consider the product of these two matrices. Here, the product of these two matrices is defined as number of columns in this matrix is 3, whereas the number of rows is also equal to 3. Since both are same, you can multiply these two matrices. The method already we learned in the earlier classes. So, first row, first column, you have to element wise, you have to multiply, then you have to take the sum. So, 1 into 0, 0, plus 2 into 2, 4, plus 0 into x, 0. Now, second row, first column, again you have to multiply element wise, 2 into 0, 0, plus 0 into 2, 0, plus 1 into x, x. Now, third row, first column, again you have to multiply element wise, 1 into 0, 0, plus 0 into 2, 0, plus 2 into x, 2x, which is equal to 0. Now, I will simplify this. That is, matrix 1, 2, 1 into 4x, 2x is equal to 0. Now, this is of order 1 cross 3 and this matrix is of order 3 cross 1. The number of columns in the first equal to number of rows in the second. So, you can multiply these two matrices. Now, you will find the product. So, for the matrix 1, 2, 1 and 4x, 2x is equal to 0. So, first row, first column, multiply element wise, then you have to take this sum. So, 1 into 4, 4 plus 2 into x, 2x plus 1 into 2x, 2x. So, this is a 0 minus. Now, add those. So, 4 plus 4x is equal to 0. Since order of this is 1 cross 1, 0 matrix is also of the same order. Already by the equality of two matrices, if the two matrices are equal, then the corresponding elements are also equal. From that condition, we have 4 plus 4x equal to 0 implies 4x will be equal to minus 4, or the value of x equal to minus 1. So, if x equal to minus 1, then only the given product equal to 0. Now, from homework question, find x if x minus 5 minus 1 1 0 2 0 2 1 2 0 3 into x 4 1 is equal to matrix 0. Second procedure as earlier, Now, next problem. That is third question. Find the matrix X so that X into the matrix 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is equal to minus 7, minus 8, minus 9, 2, 4, 6. In earlier problem, you have to find the value of X, that is a number, but here you have to find matrix X. See, I will consider it. Suppose order of X be m cross n. See here they given X into this matrix. It's of order 2 cross 3. Here X is of order m cross n. And the resultant matrix is again a matrix of order 2 cross 3. See, X, the product of X into this matrix holds only if the number of columns in X equal to number of rows. From this you can write n is equal to 2. So number of columns in X must be 2. Now in order to find the row, if order of X is n cross n and order of this matrix is 2 cross 3, then the resultant matrix is of order n cross 3. Since this product equal to this matrix, n cross 3 must be equal to 2 cross 3. So, from this, n is equal to 2. So, if n equal to 2 and n equal to 2, let capital X be a matrix of order 2 cross 2. So, I will take a general 2 cross 2 matrix with the element A, B, C. Now, write this X in the given equation. That is, X is the matrix A, B, C into the matrix 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is equal to minus 7, minus 8, minus 9, 2, 4, 6. Now, first we have to find the product of these two matrix. So, same procedure, multiplication. First row into first column, that is A into 1, A plus B into 4, 4, A. So, this is first row, first column element. Now, first row, second column, A into 2, 2A plus B into 5, 5B. Now, first row, third column, A into 3, 3A plus B into 6, 6B. So, these are the first row elements. Now, we have to find the second row elements. That is, we have to multiply second row, first column, C plus 4D. Now, second row, second column, 2C plus 5D. And third row, third column, that is 3C plus 6D. So this is the product, which is equal to minus 7, minus 8, minus 9, 2, 4, 6. Now, this matrix is equal to this. Here order are same. Then the condition is, the corresponding elements must be same. From that, we will have set of equations. So the first row, first column element must be equal to first row, first column element. From that, we have a set of equations. That is, one is A plus 4B is equal to minus 7. Second one, 2A plus 5B is equal to minus 8. Third one, 3A plus 6B is equal to minus 9. So these three equations involving the unknowns A, B, and at the same time, we will get another three equations involving C and D. So C plus 4D equal to 2. 2C plus 5D is equal to 4. And 3C plus 6D is equal to 6. Again, these three equations involving the unknowns C and D, whereas these three involving unknowns A and D. So I will take, this is equation 1, this is equation 2. By using these two equations, I will find the value A and B. Similarly, I will take this as equation 3 and this one as equation 4. Using 3 and 4, I will find the value C and B. Now we have to solve equation 1 and 2. See, in equation 2, the coefficient of A is 2, whereas in equation 1, coefficient of A is 1. So I will make the coefficient of A as 2 in the equation 1. So you have to multiply 2 to equation 1. So equation 1 becomes 2A plus 8B is equal to minus 14. Now this can be taken as equation 1 dash. Now if I take the condition, that is equation 1 dash minus equation 2, equation 1 dash minus equation 2, the left hand side, here it is 2a minus 2a, so 2a minus 2a becomes 0, plus 8b minus 5b, that is 3b, is equal to right hand side terms, here it is minus 14, minus of minus 8, that is minus 14 plus 8. So we get 3b is equal to minus 6, or b equal to minus 2. So this is the element b we got. Now using this b, I will find the value of a. So if I put b is equal to minus 2 in equation 1, equation 1 becomes a plus 4 into b, that is minus 2, is equal to minus 7. So a minus 8 equal to minus 7 implies, if I take minus 8 to this side plus 8, minus 7 plus 8 means the value of a equal to 1. So we got b is equal to minus 2 and a is equal to minus 1. Similarly, using equation 3 and 4, we have to find the value C and D. Now see equation 3 and 4. Here the coefficient of C in equation 4 is 2, whereas coefficient of C in equation 3 is 1. So I can multiply equation 2, sorry, I can multiply equation 3 by 2. So the coefficient of C in both 3 and 4 will be same. So first we have to do is multiply equation 3 by 2, then we get 2C plus 8D equal to 4. I will take this as equation 3 dash. Now equation 3 dash minus equation 4, 2C minus 2C getting cancelled, plus 8D minus 5, that is 3D, is equal to 4 minus 4. So we get 3D equal to 0 implies D equal to 0. Now using this D value, I can find the value of C using one of the equation. So put the D equal to 0 in equation 3 dash. So here we have 2c plus 8 into 0, 0 equal to 4. From this 2c is equal to 4 or c equal to 4. So once I get all the 4 values, therefore the capital X equal to, in the place of A, I have to write 1, B minus 2, C 2 and D 0. So this is the required matrix, capital X. Now we will do some multiple choice questions. First question. The number of all possible matrices of order 3 cross 3 with each entry 0 or 1 is option A 27, option B 80, option B 81 and option D 500. So the question is the number of all possible matrices of order 3 cross 3 with each entry is either 0 or 1. See, the question given is the matrix is of order 3 cross 3. So there must be 3 rows and 3 columns. So if order is 3 cross 3, then the total number of elements in the matrix will be equal to 3 into 3, that is 9. So here we can have, there are totally 9 vacant places and each vacant place can be filled by either 0 or 1, that is the first row, first column vacant space can be filled by either the element 0 or 1. So there are totally 2 possible places. Similarly, the first row, second column element vacant space, again we can fill by either 0 or 1. So there are totally 2 possible. So similar to this, we have totally 9 vacant places and each vacant place can be filled in 2 different ways. So, 2 into 2 into so on up to 2, that is how many times? 9 times using multiplication theorem, that is 2 to the power 9. The value 2 to the power 9 is 5, 2. So, the number of possible matrices of order 3 cross 3 with each entry 0 or 1 is 5 to 1. Here you see we have to use just like this, that is there are totally 9 vacant places and each vacant places can be filled in two ways, that is either the element 0 or 1. Then using the multiplication theorem, we have 2 into 2 into 2 9 times. So answer is 2 to the power 9, that is 5, 2. So option D is the answer, 5, 2, 1. Second question. Let capital X, be a matrix of order 2×n by of order 3×k and Z of order 2×p. W is of order n×3 and P is of order p×k respectively. Then first sub question. The restriction on n, k and p so that py plus w by will be defined are option A, k equal to 3, p equal to n, option B, k is arbitrary, and p is equal to 2, option C, p is arbitrary and k equal to 3, and option D, none of the above. So they given totally 5 matrices of different order. Now the first question is the restriction of n, k and p so that py plus wy will be different. First, py plus wy, order of matrix P is p×k, order of y is 3×k, order of w n×3 and order of y 3×k. Now the product py is defined only if the columns in P equal to rows in Y. So from this condition we will get the value k equal to 3. That is, py is defined only if the number of columns in P equal to number of rows in Y. From this condition we get the value k equal to 3. So this is one condition. Now the resultant order of py, the resultant order of py will be p×k. The resultant order of py be p×k. Now let us come to this problem. Order of w is n×3, order of y is 3×k. The product wy is defined only if number of columns in w equal to number of rows in y. Here both are 3, so the product wy is defined. So the resultant order of wy will be n×k. So we got order of py is p×k and order of wy is n×k. Since we have to add both py and wy in order to add any two matrices, the condition required is order must be same. From that condition, p×k must be equal to n×k. Already k, we got the value 3. So the condition must be equal to, p must be equal to, and then only py plus wy will be defined. So out of 4 options, one condition we got is k equal to 3, another condition we got is p equal to n. So out of 4 options, option A is the correct answer. Option A, that is k equal to 3 and p equal to n. Now for the same question, write Right, second subquestion. If n is equal to p, then order of the matrix 7x minus 5z is option A, p cross 2, option B, 2 cross n, option C, n cross 3, and option D, p cross n. Already given, x is of order 2 cross n and z is of order 2 cross p. See, already from the scalar multiplication of a matrix, we know that if A is of order m cross n, then KA is also of same order. There is no change in the order if we multiply by scale. So if x is of order 2 cross n, then 7x is also of the same order. Similarly, 5z is of order 2 cross n. Now we have to take the difference. So if we take the difference between any two matrix, then the condition required is order must be same. From that, 2 cross n must be equal to 2 cross p. But they given n is equal to p. So either the answer is 2 cross n or 2 cross p. Out of these two, which one is in the option? We have 2 cross n. So option B is the answer. So if n equal to p, then the order of 7x minus 5z is 2 cross n. Now the third question. If A, B are symmetric matrices of same order, then AB minus BA is option A, skew symmetric matrix, option B, symmetric matrix, option C, zero matrix, and option D, identity matrix. So the question given is, if A and B are symmetric matrices of the same order, then AB minus BA is which matrix? So the given condition is A and B are symmetric. So if A is symmetric, then A transpose equal to A, and B symmetric implies B transpose equal to B. I will check the condition AB minus BA. Which transpose? So I will consider the term, that is AB minus BA whole transpose. This is of the form A minus B whole transpose. It is in the property of transpose of a matrix, that is A minus B whole transpose is A transpose minus B transpose. So this is the property. Again, AB whole transpose means it is B transpose into A transpose. Similar to this, BA whole transpose means it is A transpose into B transpose. Now using this condition, that is A transpose equal to A and B transpose equal to B, B transpose is B, A transpose A minus A B. If I take minus 1 outside, minus d a equal to some new matrix C. So it is C dash is equal to minus C. So if the C transpose equal to minus C, then matrix C must be a skew symmetric matrix. So A B minus B A is a skew symmetric matrix. So recall the definition. If A transpose equal to minus A, then A is a skew symmetric matrix. So the same condition is here. So A B minus B A is a skew symmetric matrix. So option A is the answer. Zero matrix. Option C A is a square matrix and option D none of these. So the question given is if matrix A is both symmetric and skew symmetric. So what is the condition for if A is symmetric? That is A transpose is equal to A. Again, if A is skew symmetric, then the condition is A transpose is equal to minus A. So I will take this as equation 1, this as equation 2. Now see both equations 1 and 2. The left hand side are A dash. So you can equate the right hand side, that is A must be equal to minus A. So if A equal to minus A, then this minus A will be said. That implies A plus A, 2A is equal to 0. Or A equal to 0. So if A is both symmetric and skew symmetric, then A must be a 0 minus. Or one matrix A is given, then show that some A cube minus 23A minus 40 equal to 0. So this type of question is asked for 5 marks. Or this type of question, that is, if A and B are given, then show that AB 4 transpose equal to B transpose into A transpose. So this type of question will be asked for 5 marks. So totally 5 plus 3 plus 1, total 8 mark question will be asked from 4.